This whole project has been a roller coaster of emotions. We've been through so much just to get to this point. But for now, I'm just gonna enjoy the small victories.
In the upstairs bathroom at the carriage house, we wanna go for luxury and functionality, so we went with a large blonde wood vanity that's outside the bathroom, so there's plenty of prep space for bridal parties.
So it goes right there.
Our freestanding tub has found its new home in the living room, which is gonna help give this place the boutique hotel vibe we like. In the downstairs bedroom, all of our trim work is done, and our sleek black Murphy bed is ready for a special artistic touch.
Whoa, you need some help?
Yeah. How's it going?
Good, how are you doing?
Good. Mina and I were both really inspired by one of the home's previous owners, George Shevler. We wanted to bring some of that history back into the carriage house, so we found local artist Justin Vining to do a custom mural in the carriage house.
When are you gonna do the car?
I can start right now.
The plan is to paint something on the wall behind both Murphy beds, upstairs and downstairs.
This is the first Indy car of this era I've ever painted. And I've painted quite a few Indy cars at this point. Oh, this is gonna be so good.
Oh, you guys, it looks good. Are you happy with it?
So psyched.
Super. Yeah. Are you happy with it?
I love the car, I love the house.
It's
very cool. So now the bed can still go up.
I think it's kind of genius. It's like a little surprise when people open it up.
Mm-hmm. It looks really good. We've only got a few days of work left on the carriage house before I can show it to Steve. The last of our appliances are being installed, and we're bringing in all of our furniture so we can be ready to market the carriage house for events. You guys good?
Yeah, you can put it on the ground.
Okay, we're down. Okay. While the carriage house is just one phase of this massive project, it does feel like a bit of a victory to finally have it done, considering everything we went through to get to this point. I can only hope Steve loves the place as much as I do and can really see the potential in it as an event space and rental. So, don't mind the tarps.
Yeah.
Still
under construction.
Under construction. I shouldn't have worn these shoes.
It's okay, you didn't know.
I mean, I thought it was supposed to sprinkle this morning. Yeah. That was it. It has been a very, very, very long time coming. But I'm very excited to be able to bring Steve by and show him not the whole project completed, but at least the back carriage house. What, last time you were here, it was like just framing? A little bit of framing?
Framing, yeah. Yeah, framing. This is awesome. I love the windows and the Juliet balconies there. Those are great.
The overhead door. Where we're standing is where the addition started, and you couldn't see like the old carriage house openings, and you couldn't see how tall they were.
Right.
But now that it's off, you can see like the original structure.
Yeah, it looks great.
All right, let's get out of the rain.
Excellent.
I was hoping to spend about $288,000 on this and be done in 8 weeks, but it turned out to be closer to $420,000 and 16 weeks. But it's done, and it's gorgeous.
Oh, man.
Pretty cool, huh?
Awesome. Looks great.
So, I mean, before, you didn't get any of this light. So now that that addition's off, we've got the two overhead doors that go this way. Kept the overhead one over there, and now this really can be used for, I mean, just about anything. So if you have a little band, a little like cocktail hour when it's nice, open these up, you can go out into the backyard. We finished up the space pretty quickly after we took it back over, and all the black really balances out the brick and goes with that whole industrial like loft vibe. The epoxy floors are perfect, so we can have these indoor-outdoors events. You could open the garage door. You could really use this space for anything. Like, you could have a dance floor, food tables. I mean, the sky's the limit.
Yeah, it looks really awesome. I love how it turned out.
We'll go over to, like, the first room space over here and peek into the public restroom.
Check it out.
Okay. So, public entrance. Nice. And then this is where we ended up adding the half bath. So if you want to slide that open.
All right. Oh, wow. I love the black paint.
Black on black on black.
Black on black on black on black.
The black and gold in the powder room is so sleek. It's really cool, and it helps play on that industrial loft vibe. And even though there aren't really any industrial elements in there, it's just a really good example of a little bit goes a long way. And so we've got the black and the brick and the shiny, and it's just all perfect.
When you came through the addition, you would kind of come in through this big, deep archway here, mm-hmm. and then there was a little kitchen in here. And then this room was, I think, like an apartment too.
Yeah.
But I made it a much better apartment.
Okay, cool. Let's check it out. Oh, okay. This is beautiful.
Yeah.
I love the dark wood.
This was just a room. There was like a peekaboo through the brick. Cut that out. So now it's just a nice little efficiency apartment.
Yeah, looks great.
Little, but very functional kitchen and made a full ensuite. If you're having a guest staying here that's mm-hmm. part of the wedding, a family member, it could be shut off and this isn't accessible at all. Mm-hmm. It's just an apartment for them to be in. Or you drop a little island in here, Murphy beds up, this is all mingling gathering space.
Perfect.
All you do is move a chair out of the way if you want to, stick it in the closet.
I think it's great. There's like an old Indy car.
One of the previous owners of the property was George Shebler, who is a really important person in Indy racing history. Justin did this. Justin, Vining.
Uh-huh. Okay.
With MJ.
That looks great.
Okay. Now for the piece de resistance.
All right, let's do it. Are we going upstairs? Well, it goes from like
dark to
pretty
light.
Dark to, oh my gosh. I love it so much.
Do you?
Yeah, I do.
These are custom painted black and the walls downstairs are black.
Oh my goodness.
So it really is kind of just a flip-flop. Originally, you came up here and then there was a wall right here and on the other side of the wall was barely remnants of a kitchen. There was this little like brick wood burning oven. And I don't know how the second floor was standing because they weren't even joists. I think they were like two bys. Were like toenailed into the brick. So we had to take the whole second story out and replace it with a whole new joist system. But when the whole floor joist system comes out, then at least gave me the opportunity to redo the floor plan, move the staircase. So now it's all like nice and open. So for up here, the idea is that it might be a nice vacation spot. Or if you are going to have either your like wedding here, reception here, the girls could all get ready up here. It's like light and bright, great place for makeup and hair.
Yeah.
I see like a big brunch spread with mimosas.
Mm-hmm.
It's very boutique hotel vibe, which is what I was going for.
Yeah.
Particularly with the tub over here.
Okay, let's check it out.
This was like from jump, like this vibe where the vanity is kind of open but not open, tubs out. It's just the idea that it's so leisurely.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just gonna, you know, pop in the tub and chat with you while you're drinking wine. I'm like, you know, it just feels very fancy. It's very
bougie. It does feel very fancy, yeah.
And this archway was original. So this is like the main bedroom.
Man, I love it. I love it so much. I love that green velvet couch.
Again, the idea, like we don't want giant, really hard to move furniture.
I understand.
So another Murphy bed. This one I anticipate would be used more as a bedroom, but I could also see it being up and you could have, you know, folding tables with nice linens and it's, you know, hair, makeup, whatever,
yeah.
You know, wedding or event prep.